I'm a professor in the Institute of Geoinformatics in University of Münster, and I'm also a member of the R Foundation, so I'm one of the persons who's more heavily involved in the development of packages widely used in the R spatial ecosystem. No, not at all. No. I learned from a lot of great examples. I took programming classes when I was studying physical geography. I took sort of a minor in computer science. And later on had a lot of help from other software developers and looked at a lot of code written by other people.
Okay.
I think that the nice thing is that there is a very sort of mixed audience here. Sort of people coming from more applied fields, wanting to learn applications, people involved in software development, in complex problems, in sort of big data problems, wanting to learn about technical solutions or meet up with other people. I think that's the acceleration thing. Yeah. The good thing is to sort of meet people and find out what kind of problems they have and discuss that and sort of look at what kind of things we and other people, sort of the whole R spatial community is working on developing, and see if we can align those things and sort of make more connections working and so on, really sort of the ecosystem, sort of sustainability, really. I don't have sort of really favorite tools. My recommendations are always like use whatever works for you, but also try out a lot of different things. Yeah, look at the variety and sort of try many things, and don't be scared for asking complicated questions to anyone who has been doing this for 20 years or so. Just jump into the things and ask up. So a lot of the goal of things we do is really to get communication going. Yeah, that is the sort of the larger goal in science. One is of course scientific discovery, but the other one is communicating what you find out and what you develop and how you make things possible. Yeah, I hope that we will manage to keep talking to each other. Yeah, with a lot of people we know. We see that take up of spatial data and software for spatial data analysis and spatial data science is catching up really, really quickly, and that there's it's sort of, you know, it shouldn't run out of hand and become too much for the few developers that we have. So we both need to sort of get more and young people involved and active and responsible and taking up part of the work of making this keeping this thing going, as well as respond to the outside world and sort of make sure that it doesn't fragment too much. Yeah, that would be a shame. I mean, it's an ecosystem, so fragmentation happens anyway, but the more you keep talking to each other, the more useful in the end and the more robust sort of the whole ecosystem will in the end develop. So we do that with every programming we do, sort of when we try to make a program for summer schools like this or for conferences, then we basically try to find to settle on programs where the people who present have where there's enough diversity in that group in all respects. I think that is the only thing we can do, and then people see, hey, that, you know, to become a keynote speaker or an invited speaker somewhere, I don't have to be a white male of 50 plus years old or so, right? That's not the criteria. Yeah. Yeah, in principle, I think one of the mechanisms is that the software is of course freely available, right? And the other one is that we don't discriminate against those who come with good questions. Yeah, good questions are taken as good questions and not based on where they come from or how well funded the party that asks a question is. There are hundreds, if not thousands, papers already available on on analysis of COVID data, but if you just read them and all of this is not reproducible, how much could you trust it, right? So as long as you analyze things transparently and make things reproducible, make it clear where the data comes from, and if the data is open data, then it's much easier to build trust and to make decisions based on those kind of papers. So I think that to for science, if it wants to maintain or increase its role in sensible political solutions, then it really needs to sort of embrace open science principles, and their open source is one of the criteria, right?